Shalom and welcome to another weekly Bible study as we continually rightly divide the word of Yahweh as a workman. Now, we are coming into the Kairos time or the divine time, or we could say the Moed, the Hebrew word, or the Greek word Kairos, which means one of the feasts of the Lord, which is Passover. That is the first feast of Yahweh, and that's when the Messiah went to the cross on Passover and fulfilled the rehearsals that was given to the children of Israel through God to Moses. And that Passover was a rehearsal or a holy convocation that was kept once a year, the 14th day of Nisan. That the Nisan is the first month. God's calendar goes by first month, second month, third month through the 12th month. Also the first day of the week, second day of the week, third day of the week. The Sabbath's on the seventh day of the week, which is our Saturday, if we're on the correct calendar. Now, I don't have much time. This is only about a 30-minute study. I have been studying the calendar, or a calendar that is called the Enoch calendar. Now, some people, there's lots of people who come in familiar with that, that especially they're keeping the feast and the holy days and the Sabbaths. You have the Jewish calendar that is kept by the moon. In other words, the moon, you have a lunar calendar, you have a solar lunar, you have a solar. So you have all these calendars. Now, in reflection to these calendars, I would only be talking to people that understand the Sabbath and follow the holy days. To Sunday worshipers, which most proclaim to study or worship on Sunday, Wednesday, or during the week, or Christmas and Easter and all those pagan holidays. But to people that understand that following the Sabbath and the holy days, there is a discrepancy there because there's three or four different calendars. So I do believe that God is, the times of refreshing have come. That means the times are being restored, divine days, the holy days, and that would include the calendar. Now, to study Enoch's calendar, you have the book of Enoch, you have the book of Jubilees, the book of Jasher, and the Dead Sea Scrolls. I have been studying the Dead Sea Scrolls for a couple of months now because we have this Passover, the season of Passover. Now, just to give you, for instance, for most people that are Sunday worshipers or go to church on Sunday, will celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, which is called Easter Sunday. That's the 27th of March. You have the Jewish calendar. By the lunar, that the Passover or Pesach this year will be the 23rd of April. So you have the Catholics and the most Christians that will celebrate Easter Sunday as the resurrection of the Messiah. You have the Jewish, a lot of your Jewish followers or Orthodox or Jewish as far as Messianic believers, they celebrate the 23rd of April. Now, according to the studying of the Enoch calendar, is a 364-day calendar, a perfect 52-week calendar given to Enoch from the heavens. It's also the heavenly calendar. That's right, that the heavens are also on this same calendar. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And so that calendar was passed on to Noah and after the flood through his sons, but it has been lost several different times because of the apostate of Israel, or following Abraham, picked it back up, Isaac and Jacob, and then through the splitting of the kingdoms, and it got lost again. And when Christ came, he was faced with these Babylonian priests. But there was the Nazarenes, or the Essenes, That's where in 1947 you had the what they call the Dead Sea Scrolls that were found. In the Dead Sea Scrolls were found these writings of Isaiah and the Old Testament, plus the Book of Jubilees, plus the Book of Enoch. So that was in Qumran there, in that cave there, where they found, the Arab found these parchments of these writings, which have been studied now for the last 20 or 25 years or so. And so some of the studying is coming out now, is being released. And what we're finding, people, for those that are interested, and I know that most of you people that worship on Sunday could care less about what I'm talking about, but for those that do have an interest, you have what they call the priestly order. That's the 24 courses that even David ordained and ordered out of 1 Chronicles 24. Very important, as we get into this, we're going to see that how correct not only God's calendar is, but we have the priestly order of the Zadok priest after the order of Melchizedek that keep in the third heaven, that follow this order as these priests work. The 24 elders there that you see in the book of Revelation represents the heavenly 24 orders or 24 elders of the priestly order. Just like David had, John the Baptist's father was from the eighth course of Abijah. We see that in Luke, first chapter. So this is what's happening. There's lots of studying now coming through Enoch and through the calendar that people are now starting to study. So I guess in short, I'm going to say our celebration, or I will celebrate the Passover, according to the calendar, the 12 hours in a day, one time a year. It's the same time every year that is recorded in the Enoch calendar. It does not change. So all the holy days and the Sabbaths are constant year after year after year. All the feast days fall on the same time every year on the 364-day calendar. Now, according to Enoch's calendar, the 23rd of this month, which was the time this video hits, is going to be 2 or 3 weeks past, was the 23rd of March. That would be the first day of Nisan, or the first day of the new month or the new year on God's calendar. It was also a full moon recorded on the 23rd. Now, the full moon records every 3 years. It will fall on the same day of the first day of the year. But the calendar is not by the moon. That's just the light that's in the moon. It will be full every third year. From now, I mean, if you go all the way back or forward, since the day is of Noah, it doesn't change. So we are now finding that God's true calendar is divisible by seven. If you divide seven into 364 days, you get 52 weeks. Perfect. And so the 364th day ended on Tuesday, the 22nd of March. The calendar always starts on the new year, always, people. It's according to the creation calendar, and the fourth day, or Wednesday, is the middle of the week, and that's the first day of the new year every year. So 364 days from the 23rd on Enoch's calendar, as we go all the way around, near 2017, the last day of the year will be on a Tuesday, the 364th day. That following day on Wednesday in the middle of the week will be the first day of God's new year. And it will also be the 12-hour day. So that's when Christ told his apostles, if you understand the 12-hour day, you walk in light, not in darkness. We'll see that here in John 11. So I want to read to you real quick in the book of Jubilees. We're going to see that we'll read right here. For this reason it is ordained and written on. Now Moses wrote the book of Jubilees. It's called the Little Genesis. For this reason ordained and written on the heavenly tables, that they should celebrate the Feast of Weeks in the month once a year to renew the covenant every year. This whole festival was celebrated in heaven from the day of creation to the days of Noah. 26 Jubilees and 5 weeks of the years. Noah and his sons observed it, 7 Jubilees and 1 week of years till the day of Noah's death. And from the day of Noah's death, the sons did away with it until the days of Abraham, and they ate blood, the Bible says. I mean, the Jubilee says. But Abraham observed it, and Isaac and Jacob, and the children observed it up to thy days, and in thy days the children of Israel forgot it until they celebrated it anew on the mountain. Do this command the children of Israel to observe this festival, all their generations, for the commandment unto them. One day in the year, in this month, they shall celebrate the festival. For the Feast of Weeks and the Feast of First Fruits, this feast twofold, and of a double nature, according to what is written and engraven concerning it, to celebrate it. For I have written in the book of the first law, that which I have written for thee, that thou shouldest celebrate it in the season, one day in this year, and I explained it to thee in sacrifices, that the children of Israel should remember and should celebrate throughout their generations in this month, one day in every year. And on the new month, or the new moon of the first month, and on the new moon of the fourth month, and on the new moon of the seventh month, and on the new moon of the 10th month are the days of remembrance. And these days of the seasons in the four divisions of the year, these are written and ordained for testimony forever. And Noah ordained them for himself as feasts for the generations forever, so that they have become thereby a memorial unto him. And on the new moon of the first month, it is bidden him to make for himself an ark, and on that day the earth became dry. And open the ark and shall the earth. And on the new moon in the fourth month of the mouths of the depths of the abysses beneath were closed. And on the new moon of the seventh month, all the mouths of the abysses of the earth were open, and waters began to descend and do them. And on the new moon of the 10th month, the tops of the mountains were seen, and Noah was glad. And on this account, he adorned himself as feast for more forever, and they are ordained. And they placed them on the heavenly tables each 13 weeks from one to another, passed their memorial to the first, the second, and second to third, and third to the fourth. In other words, what's happening here is you have a 360-day calendar, 12 30-month days, but you have these four season days. After the flood, you had wintertime and summertime, heat and cold, and days of night and day. So, in other words, Enoch's calendar runs, it started on the 23rd, the first month of the month, the 23rd of March. We will count 30 days for the first month, you'll count another 30 days for the second month, and you'll count 30 days for the third month. And at the end of those 30 days, you'll add one day. That's these remembrance days. And that will give you 91 days. In that quarter, or 13 weeks. 13 weeks times 4 is 52 weeks. It's all perfectly mathematically correct. So, but we see that after Noah died after the flood, 350 years after the flood, that the sons and the generations of his sons, they lost the remembrance days and they did not follow them, and therefore the feasts were lost. You had people celebrating feasts on unclean days, the book of Jubilee says. So here it says, as we continue here, thus is engraven and ordained on the heavenly tables, and there's no lecting the commandment for a single year or from year to year. And command the children of Israel that they observe the years according to the reckoning, 364 days. And these will constitute a complete year. And they will not disturb its time from its days and from its feast. For everything will fall out in them according to their testimony. And they will not leave out any day nor disturb any feast. In other words, if we keep the 364-day calendar, everything falls out perfect. But if they do neglect and do not observe them according to his commandment, then they will disturb all the seasons, and the years will be dislodged from this order. And they will disturb the seasons, and the years will be dislodged, and they will neglect their ordinances. And all the children of Israel will forget, and will not find the path of the years, and will forget the new months and seasons, Sabbaths, and they will go wrong as to all the order of the years. For I know, and from henceforth shall I declare it to thee, and it is not of my own devising, for the book lieth written before me, and on the heavenly tables the division of days is ordained. Lest they forget the feast of the covenant, and walk according to the feast of Gentiles, after their error and after their ignorance. For there will be those who will assuredly make observations of the moon. That's where the moon calendar comes in. Now it disturbs the seasons and cometh in from year to year 10 days too soon. This is a Jewish calendar. Theirs is a 354-day year. Enoch's is 364. For the reason the years will come up on them when they will disturb the order and make an abominable day the day of testimony and an unclean day a feast day. And they will confound all the days, the holy with the unclean, and the unclean day with the holy. For they will go wrong as to the months of Sabbaths and the feast and the jubilees. For this reason I command testify to thee that thou mayest testify to them. For after thy death thy children will disturb them, so that they will not make the year 364 days only. And for this reason they will go wrong as to the new months and seasons, Sabbaths and festivals, and they will eat all kinds of blood and all kinds of flesh. Okay, now what does that mean, eat all kinds of blood and all kinds of flesh? Well, because Paul says, we cannot be partakers of the Gentiles' table or the table of devils. See, we can't eat the unclean there. That's, you can't partake of idols or devils, and that means distribute portions to self. You can only partake of the Lord's table, people. Paul reveals that in 1 Corinthians there. So it's very important that we understand this. Now, a lot of people are going to say, I've never heard of the book of Jubilees, I've never heard of the book of Enoch. Well, the book of Enoch, in the New Testament, Old Testament, Paul's writings, and the Old Testament, there's lots of scripture, people, taken from the book of Enoch. Lots of scripture when you study that. So Enoch is quoted a lot in the Bible, in other words, in the Old Testament, New Testament. Got to remember, when they found the Dead Sea Scrolls, they also found the book of Jubilees and the book of Jasher and the book of Enoch with those writings of the Old Testament. So I just kind of want to go over some of that because I will be, Lord willing, will be following from now on the Enoch calendar, which all of the feasts and the Sabbaths are recorded, and they rotate every year the same days. The same days every year, Passover will always be on the 14th day, which will be 14 days from the 23rd on March this year. That Tuesday, Passover will be April the 5th. The first day of unleavened bread will be April the 6th, and that will be a high Sabbath and will run for 7 days, the first and the last day will be no work days. So I wanted to bring that in, and Lord willing, as we continue in our studies in this coming year, we will look at the priestly calendar. We will even see what priest was working the week that Christ raised Lazarus from the dead, and we'll understand what priest was working when Christ was died on the cross and was raised from the dead that week, and also his first fruits being resurrected. So we will see that in 1 Chronicles 24. We'll get into that teaching as we get into the season. Okay, I want to pick it up here. I don't have much time left. I want to pick it up in John 11, the second chapter. It was that Mary, which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. So the Mary that was the sister of Lazarus, we're going to see, a week after Christ raised Lazarus from dead, that he went and ate supper with them. And this is when Mary was preparing his feet for his burial. Therefore his sister said unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom thou lovest is sick. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God be glorified thereby. Now, Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus, and when he heard therefore that he was sick, he abode 2 days still in the same place where he was. Then after that said to his disciples, let us go to Judea again. Notice what the disciples said, people. His disciples said unto him, Master, the Jews of late sought to stone thee. And goest thou hither again? Yeshua answered, art there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbles not, because he seeth the light of this world. Now, see, the day, what is Christ talking about here, people? What is he talking about 12 hours in the day? You have, on God's calendar, you have a day that has the closest to 12-hour day and a 12-hour night. That comes in the spring. That is when God's calendar starts, people. Now, the apostles did not know what he was talking about here. But notice how he, the context, are there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he seeth the light. Now, so the light, people, the light and the walk in the light, in the context, what is he talking about? He's talking about those that are following God's calendar and his divine days. You will not stumble. You are children of the light, not darkness. The world is in darkness. That's why when God said, don't keep the customs of the heathen, or don't learn the ways of the heathen, because God created the divine days for his people, the children of light. The world is in darkness, people, and so you got to understand that the Kairos times, or the Moeds, is coming to the light. See, walking in the light. See, this is what Christ is talking about. Now, when Paul says in 1 Thessalonians 5:1, brethren, I don't need to write to you about the times and the seasons. Well, see, because they were in the light. That's why he said the thief is going to come in the night, and when they say peace and safety, then sudden destruction. But you're not children of the night, Paul said. You're children of the day. You're children of the light. Why? Because they was on God's calendar, people. That's what this is all about. It has not been nailed to the cross. It is still relevant for us, those that are following the Messiah. This is when all prophecy has been fulfilled, will be fulfilled, or has yet been fulfilled. So, now we continue here. So, the context here, now what I want you to see is, on the 364th day of Enoch's calendar, this was the end of the year. And then starting on Wednesday, the middle of the week, the 23rd of March, that starts the new year. That starts the first day of the new year. So Christ is, now he's coming back to Judah there. He's coming back. They had left because they tried to stone Christ to death. Then he gets a message from Martha that Lazarus is sick and he's dying. And of course, he says, I'm going to stay here another 2 days. Now, in verse 10, 11, 10, but if a man walk in the night, he stumbleth because there is no light in him. Well, because he's not on God's divine days. He's not following the Sabbath and the holy days, people. That's what he's talking about. You can't walk in other days and know who God is. That's why Christ says you'll stumble. These things said he after that, he saith, Lazarus sleepeth, but I go that I may wake him out of his sleep. Then said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, he do well. How bad? Jesus spoke of the death, but they thought that he had spoken of taking of rest. In other words, taking a nap. Then said Yeshua unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. And I am glad for your sakes that I was not there to the intent you may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him. Then said Thomas, which is called Didymus, unto his fellow disciples, let us also go that we may die with him. Now, why? But they thought that when Christ goes back, the Jews are going to stone him to death, so we'll be with him, they can stone us to death, and we'll die together. They did not understand the times and the signs of the times. Christ would die as the sacrifice lamb, the lamb slain before the foundation of the world. So when Yeshua came, he found that he had in the grave, notice, 4 days already. Why 4 days, people? Now, here, if we understand God's calendar, the Enoch calendar, the 12-hour day is a marker that tells us that is in the spring, and that will mark the beginning of the new month. That's what the Lord is saying. If you're on that, then you know when the new month starts. If you know when the new month starts, you know when Passover is, you know when unleavened bread is, you know when first fruits, you know when Pentecost, you know when the feast in the seventh month come. And it goes around and around every year until the fullness of those times come in. See, that's at the end of the age. So these feasts of the Lord will continue, but there is a correct calendar to which they should be celebrated on. And that's what the Lord is revealing now because he's soon to come. Now, very important, Christ mentions 12-hour days. Now he's waited 4 days. So the 12-hour day would come on the 364th day. If you back up 4 days, Lazarus had been dead from the first day of the week, the second, and the Sabbath to the first, the second, and the third day of the week, people. So Christ raised Lazarus from the dead on the same time. On the 12-hour day, people. That's when he rested. That was set. In other words, that's why he gave you 4 days. That's why he gave you the 12-hour day. And the thing about it is, what you got to see is, he's coming to die on the cross at Passover. So what does this resurrection of Lazarus has to do? The will of the Father. See, now we're going to see this. When Martha says this, you got to, everything is said and has to do with fulfilling a prophecy. Okay, now, Lazarus had already been dead 4 days. Now, Bethany was nigh to Jerusalem about 15 furlongs off, and many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary, comforted them concerning their brother. Then Martha, as soon as she had heard Yeshua was coming, went and met him. But Mary sat still in the house. Now Mary was the one that will wash his feet the next week. And so we probably won't get to that. That's in John 12. Now, then said Martha to Jesus, Lord, if thou had been here, my brother had not died. But I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it to thee. Yahshua saith unto her, thy brother shall rise again. Now, I want to show you, now this rise again here, G450 in the Greek, is another word for the resurrection. To stand up means to stand up, lift up, raise up again, rise again, stand upright. So Christ said to Martha, thy brother shall rise again. Now, this is a Greek word that Christ used. Now, if you look in the interlinear, let me go to the interlinear here, the inner Greek text here, and you're going to see right here this word rise again. Here's your Greek word. It's a verb. It's in the future middle indicative voice, singular. So this is the future active voice, people. So Christ was telling her that Lazarus would rise again in the resurrection, in the future. Okay, now notice what Martha says right here. Notice what Martha says. Now notice, Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. In is the preposition, means state or time or state, in the exitos, in the last day. Now people, in the last day, Martha said, and when she said unto him, this means to relate in words, a speech, to break silence, that I know, the word I know is idio, and it means to know, be aware, behold, she understood this, that Lazarus would again in the future, same word, for resurrection here, rise is G450. And the resurrection means to come to life after dying at the last day. Now, people, I want to show you now, how did Martha know this? This is in John 11. Why did Martha tell Yahshua vehemently that her brother would be raised in the resurrection at the last day? How did Martha know this? Well, let's look and see real quick. Very important to study all of Christ's teaching. When we go to John the 6th chapter, we're going to see exactly where Martha was learning this as Christ taught this. All right, we're going to see in John 6, 37. All that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that cometh to me I will no wise cast out. For Christ came down from heaven not to do his will, but the will of him that sent me, his Father, the Father's will. And this is the Father's will which has sent me, that all of which he gives to me I shall lose nothing, but should raise it up again. Here is the same Greek word, people. Antistome, it means to rise again, G450. Notice that I will raise it up again at the last day. So Martha and Lazarus and Mary, they all been followers of Yahshua. And look in verse 40. And this is the will of them that sent me, that everyone seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life. And notice, how did Martha know? I will raise him up at the last day. So this is how Martha and Mary and Lazarus, and also this is what we know, because we know that we know what Martha and Lazarus, because we're believers in Yeshua, we're following Yeshua, and he's telling you. So that her brother shall rise future. When? Martha says, at the last day. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. So now Christ is going to raise Lazarus from the dead as a sign for us that we will believe by faith that even though we die in Christ and are buried, that we will, even though being dead, we shall live, how? In the resurrection. Because he is the resurrection and life. Whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die unto the age. This is what the three Greek words are. Into, right here, eis. It means into, and this G165 means age. Believest thou this? She said to him, yeah, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of God, which should come into the world. And when she had said so, he went her way and called Mary, her sister, secretly, saying, the master is come and calleth for thee. As soon as she heard, she arose quickly and came unto him. Now, Yeshua was not yet come unto the town, but was in that place where Martha met him. The Jews then were there, her in the house, and comforted her when they saw Mary, that she rose up hastily and went out, followed her, saying, she goeth into the grave to weep there. Then when Mary was come there, Yeshua was, and saw him, she fell down at his feet, saying to him, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother was not died. When Jesus therefore saw her weeping, and the Jews also weeping, which came with her, he groaned in the spirit and was troubled, and said, where have you laid him? They said to him, Lord, come and see. Jesus wept, then said to the Jews, behold how he loved him. And some of them said, could not this man which opened the eyes of the blind have caused that even this man should not have died? Yeshua therefore again groaning in himself cometh to the grave. It was a cave and a stone laid upon it. Jesus said, take away the stone. Martha, the sister of him, said to him, unto him, Lord, by this time, 4 days, he stinketh, for he hath been dead 4 days. Jesus said unto her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid, and Yeshua lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee, thou hast heard me at all times, but because of the people which stand by, I said that if thou mayest believe, thou hast sent me. And when thus he had spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot, and grave clothes, and his face was bound about a napkin. And Jesus said to him, loosen him, let him go. Then many of the Jews which came to Mary and had seen the things which Yeshua did believed on him, but some of them went their way to the Pharisees and to them to tell them what things Yeshua had done. Then gathered the chief priests and the Pharisees a council and said, what do we do? For this man doeth many miracles. Okay, so we close here, people. We got to understand, because of the raising of Lazarus, you had Jews that go to the chief priests, the Pharisees, and they're going to set a council and get together of how they are going to kill the master. And of course, we know that this is going to happen. 14 days later, Christ will die. You got to understand that the next day starts the new year. So 14th day of Nisan is when Messiah will die on the cross. Lazarus here was resurrected on the last day of Enoch's calendar, people. That's what all of this we're going to come to see as we learn the correct calendar. And that's why Christ said 12 hours in a day. That's why that this marker marks the beginning of the new year. And if you're on that calendar, then Passover, unleavened bread, first fruits, Pentecost, and the fall feast all work out to the exact days every year. So we'll pick this back up in our future studies, Lord willing. My God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, may that spirit witness to your spirit as we traded these scriptures with one another. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and soon coming King to do the will of the Father. And that's to raise those that are in the Messiah at the last day. In his name we ask. Amen.